Hello everybody, welcome to the Java course. If you want to set up a constant, you can make use of the final keyword. But if you want to set up a group of constants, we can have another method by using the Enum data type. Enum here means enumerate. That means we are going to create a data type. All of the contents inside this data type are all constants. So how can we create an Enum data type? We can go to the src folder on the left hand side, and then we right click new Enum, and then I can set up the name of this Enum data type. For my case, I call it direction, and then I press finish. Okay, I will have an Enum data type called direction. In this data type, I can do something like this. So we want to represent a group of constants, say the directions. We can create the Enum data type, and then we can put the directions into the contents. Okay, I use all capital letters to represent the directions. It is quite common for people to use capital letters to represent some values that are not going to change after it is set up. So it is customary for Java developers to use capital letters to represent some constant values. So here I define some directions for which is contained in an enum type called direction. Let me save it. So now I have Enum data type called directions. So how can I make use of the constants shown on the direction data type? I can do something like this on the Java program. Okay, I now create a reference variable called my orientation, and this reference variable is pointing to the object indicating the direction, which is west. And then I can treat this reference variable my orientation as follows. Okay, if my orientation is equal to the north, which is a constant given by the direction enum data type, I will print this statement out. You are facing north. If it is not the case, I would just say that I'm not facing north. So let me see the result by saving it and running it. Okay, the answer is you are not facing north, because the west direction is not equal to the north direction. So we can make use of the equality signs to compare two constants coming from the Enum data type. And for Enum data types, we can have more functionalities or more features to discuss. We can make use of the values method from an enum data type to give us an array of enum type elements. What does it mean by that? Let us see an example to illustrate this property. Okay, for this assignment statement, I'm going to assign the enum data types to an array whose reference is stored in this reference variable called myArray. So this reference variable is pointing to an array that stores the directions shown in the enum data type. What does it mean by this? We can simply display the content stored in the array. I can print out the contents together with the ordinal number shown in the direction enum data type. What does it mean by the ordinal number? It means the order displayed in the enum data type. So east will be 0, south will be 1, west will be north, will be 2, and north will be 3. Let us see the result by printing both the element and the ordinal number. The ordinal number is given by the ordinal method of an element of the array produced by the values method. Okay, let me save it and run it. Okay, east is the first element of the my array. South is the second element of my array. West is the third element of my array, and north is the fourth element of my array. And the ordinal number is as follows: 0 for east, 1 for south, 2 for west, and 3 for north. So the ordinal number simply follows the order listed in the direction enum data type, which is on the right hand side of the screen. So we can make use of the values method of an enum data type to print out the content stored in each enum data type. And together with the ordinal method, we can see the ordinal number of each element in the enum data type. So I hope you're able to have some idea of using enum data type as the approach of storing some constant values of some groups. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, feel free to leave your comments on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.